All right, guys, this is another cheesy video on mentally delayed rollback rifles. And this video is for Nathaniel Serta, I believe is the guy's name. I was watching his PTR video. I think if other PTR guys are like me, we all kind of watch each other's channels. He calls it the poor man's scar, which I would have to agree. That's a good description. But these are not shitty rifles. For the money, this scar, people selling the scar are tripping, because these are not that worse than a scar in the great scheme of things, because these are actually modular. And the scar, I believe they've redesigned the butt stock and all kinds of stuff several times. So this is a proven classic. But what he was wanting to know is the retractable stock. He was thinking about trying to machine the grooves in it. Now, one thing I will say about these, hold on one second, this is awkward from behind the camera. One thing about this is, with the retractable stock, if you get one of these with a multi-position retractable stock, it will be more difficult to retract or change positions. It is a two-handed operation, whereas it's like a hand and a half to adjust the regular retractable stocks. But oh shit, sorry, my camera's moving. So with this thing, from what I understand and all the research I've done, there's not a lot on YouTube about this. Very few videos are from me on the G3 retractable stocks on YouTube. For whatever reason, these aren't popular. There's a lot of guys. It's mostly an AR thing where people get cheek weld. Bolt action rifles and AR-15s is where you get that beautiful cheek weld. Now, I think it's kind of a sissy, someone's pretty much admitting that they're a sissy shooter to me if they have to have good cheek weld. Yeah, you'll be a little bit more accurate for long shots, but you know, if you train around a retractable stock, I think it will do you good. And the amount of space and everything these things give you when you need it to get smaller and retract down to the lowest is a benefit. But from the research I've seen, if you machine these wrong, then it'll screw it up. Let me try to give you a close up. I have an MP5 retractable stock, and I have this one. When I ordered it, they sent me the I ordered the El Cheapo regular German retractable stock, the where it goes all the way forward and all the way back, and they sent me the more expensive one, and I'm kind of glad because I like it in the middle. But if you look, these notches would kind of be difficult to do unless you have machine work. So collapse down. That's about where I like it, in the middle. But since I put this scope on it, I probably would need to have it about all the way out. So, yeah. That's about all I was going to say. If you need any more info or pictures, let me know.